Greetings. I wanted to continue examining Islam's basic problems of logic. Can any prophet declare he is the last? This is an interesting problem for Islam. Why? Because two prophets declared they were the last. Now, either a prophet can reveal that he is the last, or he cannot. But a prophet can reveal he is the last only if that is God's message. If a prophet claims he is the last and is not, he is a false prophet. If a prophet claims he is the last and is a true prophet, he must be the last. So who are the two prophets who claimed or taught they were the last? For example, would it make sense to claim Solomon was the last? No, because clearly many prophets came after Solomon. So logically, a real prophet who claimed to be last would, in fact, be the last real prophet. Again, who are the two prophets who claimed or taught they were the last? Jesus and Mohammed. Where did Jesus claim or teach that he was the last prophet from God? Luke 20:9-19, the parable of the tenants. He went on to tell the people this parable. A man planted a vineyard, rented it to some farmers, and went away for a long time. At harvest time, he sent a servant to the tenants so they would give him some of the fruit of the vineyard. But the tenants beat him and sent him away empty-handed. He sent another servant, but that one also they beat and treated shamefully and sent away empty-handed. And he sent still a third, and they wounded him and threw him out. Then the owner of the vineyard said, "What shall I do? I will send my son, whom I love. Perhaps they will respect him." But when the tenants saw him, they talked the matter over. "This is the heir," they said. "Let's kill him, and the inheritance will be ours." They conspire as if killing the son ends the issue. That can only be true if the son is the last possible messenger. So they threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. What, then, will the owner of the vineyard do to them? He will come and kill those tenants and give the vineyard to others. Now when the people heard this, they said, "God forbid!" Jesus looked directly at them and asked, "Then what is the meaning of that which is written, 'The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone'? Everyone who falls on that stone will be broken to pieces. Anyone on whom it falls will be crushed." The teachers of the law and the chief priests looked for a way to arrest him immediately, because they knew he had spoken this parable against them. But they were afraid of the people. This same parable is repeated in Mark 12:1-12. In Mark 12:6, he had one left to send, a son whom he loved. He sent him last of all, saying, "They will respect my son." In this rendition, it reads, "one left to send," meaning the last. This same parable is repeated in Matthew. Matthew 21:37, "Last of all, he sent his son to them. They will respect my son," he said. This clearly states the son would be the last messenger. Now, some might attempt to contest the term last. However, in all three contexts, the tenants thought that killing the son would end the issue. So Jesus taught that he was the son sent to the tenants. And that fact is again established by the context. In Luke 20:19, The teachers of the law and the chief priests looked for a way to arrest him immediately, because they knew he had spoken this parable against them. When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard Jesus' parable, they knew he was talking about them. Mark 12:12. Then the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders looked for a way to arrest him, because they knew he had spoken the parable against them. So clearly Jesus taught that he was the Son in the story. It was such a thinly disguised parable that the Jewish leaders knew it was against them. And Jesus, acting as a prophet, taught that he would be the last messenger from God. One other verse to look at before leaving this. In Luke 20:16, he will come and kill those tenants and give the vineyard to others. What then will the owner of the vineyard do? He will come and kill those tenants and give the vineyard to others. This sounds a lot like something else Jesus said. Matthew 21:43, therefore I tell you that the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people who will produce its fruit. Vineyard, kingdom, given to a people who will produce its fruit. Can you see the parallel? Of course, Islam is all over this verse, attempting to claim it means Arabs and Islam, when in fact it actually refers to the Gentile Christians who are to spur the Jewish nation to jealousy. Romans 11:14, for I want somehow to make the people of Israel jealous of what you Gentiles have, so I might save some of them. Ultimately, that is the purpose and plan of God: to honor and fulfill his covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And what of the other prophet who claimed to be last? Quran 33:40. Mohammed is not the father of any of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the last of the prophets, and Allah is cognizant of all things. So Mohammed, speaking as Allah, claimed he was the last of the prophets. And in another place, in the Ubay Baka'ab Codex of the Quran, Quran 61:6, O children of Israel, I am God's or Allah's messenger to you, and I announce to you a prophet whose community will be the last community, and by which Allah will put the seal on the prophets and messengers. But this version of the Quran was changed into today's version. Quran 61:6, remember when Jesus, son of Mary, said, O children of Israel, I am sent to you by God, confirming the Torah that came before me and bringing good news of a messenger to follow me, whose name will be Ahmad. Yet when he came to them with clear signs, they said, this is merely sorcery. This insertion of the name will be Ahmad is one of the proven textual variants in the Quran. And yes, textual variant means a change to Allah's unchangeable word. For reference, see Material for the History of the Text of the Quran, the Old Codices, the Kitab al-Masahif of Ibn Abu Dawud, together with a collection of the variant readings of the codices of Ibn Mas'ud, Ubay, Ali, Ibn Abbas, Anas, Abu Musa, and other Quranic authorities, which present a type of text anterior to that of the canonical text of Uthman. This was written by Jeffrey Leiden and E.J. Brill in 1937. Anterior means coming before in time. So the text anterior to the canonical text of Uthman is the Quranic text before Uthman revised it. This particular ayat attempts to stand on the fact that Jesus is a true prophet. However, this alleged message from Jesus cannot be verified or corroborated. There is no record on earth of Jesus saying these words from either version of the Quran. Suffice it to summarize that the Quran repeatedly claims Jesus is a true prophet. Leaving that aside, we have two men who both claim they are the last messenger from God. Since the claim of being last means another cannot come after, both cannot be the actual last prophet of God. If Jesus is the last, is his story consistent and coherent? Yes, because Jesus, having stated he is the Son and is the last, left no ambiguous mention of a future prophet. Jesus did promise the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, who came 50 days after Jesus was resurrected from the dead. Add to that the Quran's repeated assertion that Jesus is a true prophet, and we have a strong case that Jesus is a true prophet and his claim is true. If Mohammed is the last, is his story consistent and coherent? Mohammed claimed that he was the last prophet and a true prophet. But Mohammed also claimed to confirm that Jesus was a true prophet. But if Jesus was a true prophet and Jesus claimed he was the last prophet, then Mohammed's claim that Jesus was a prophet invalidates Mohammed's own claim as a prophet. Because Mohammed cannot be a true prophet claiming to come after a true prophet who claimed to be the last. So Mohammed's claim is inconsistent with being a true prophet. Mohammed has vouched for and confirmed the claims of the previous last prophet. So it is simply illogical to accept Mohammed's claim that he is a prophet, let alone the last true prophet from the same God who sent Jesus, the Son of God, as the last messenger. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.